वर्णवयसम, वर्णवयसम, वर्णवलमुडन, बी ब्लेस्ड बाय द डिवाइन, मे द होल वर्ल्ड एंजॉय प्रॉस्पेरिटी, हैप्पीनेस एंड पीस. गुड इवनिंग एंड अ वेरी वार्म वेलकम टू वन एंड ऑल. ऑन बिहाफ ऑफ अवर वर्ल्ड कम्युनिटी सर्विस सेंटर आईटी टीम आलियर इंग्लिश स्पिरिचुअल सेशन, Let us begin the session with Priya meditation, prayer for divinity. Becoming active through the primordial state transforms into particles which then associate to clash and unite, come together and separate, form the elements, matter in five states, the planets and stars and all things that live with sensory perception from single to five, as well as man. With his ability to know right from wrong, let happiness through service grow. Pray for Guru, your gentle touch between my eyebrows awakened my life forces. Meditation at Turiya removed my imprint, revealed myself. To me, free of my imprint, one with the Absolute, I realize from whence I come. The effect of my ill deeds becoming evident. My senses I overcome, the life force within me and God in the life force, all made clear to me. The ways to win people through deeds of virtue now easy for me to see. Kayakalpa, exercises and karma yoga, all taught with the sole aim of emancipation of mankind. Beloved Guru, long live thy faith. Nadi Shuddhi Pranayama. Clearance pranayama. The atmosphere around us is being purified by the divine power. The atmosphere around us is being purified by the divine power. The atmosphere around us is being purified by the divine power. Divine power descends upon us, and our body and soul are being purified. Divine power descends upon us, and our body and soul are being purified and blessed. Divine power descends upon us, and our body and soul are being purified and blessed. May the divine power protect us, guide us, and lead us day and night, at all times, at all places, and in all our activities. Salutations to Mother, salutations to Father, and salutations to our Guru, Yogiraj Vedadri Maharishi. Turiya meditation. Start meditation at Ajna. Turiya. Be blessed by the divine. Let us conclude meditation. May the energy spread throughout the body. May the body and soul be purified. Auto-suggestion. By the grace of the divine, we will enjoy good health, long life, enough wealth, prosperity and wisdom. By the grace of the divine, we will enjoy good health, long life, enough wealth, prosperity and wisdom. By the grace of the divine, we will enjoy good health, long life, enough wealth, prosperity and wisdom. Blessing. Bless our life partner. Bless our children. Bless our brothers and sisters. Bless close relatives and friends. Bless all those who are associated with us in our day-to-day activities. Bless the enemies or miscreants, if any, so that they may also change and lead a corrected life. Vedatriyam propounded by our Guru Vedatri Maharshi, we bless the World Community Service Center, we bless the Temple of Consciousness at Aliyar, we bless Sky Trust and meditation centers all over the world, we bless all participants in this Zoom session, be blessed with divine twofold moral culture. I, in my lifetime, will not cause any suffering to the body or mind of any person. I will strive to remove the miseries of others to the extent possible. I, in my lifetime, will not cause any suffering to the body or mind of any person. I will strive to remove the miseries of others to the extent possible. I, in my lifetime, will not cause any suffering to the body or mind of any person. I will strive to remove the miseries of others to the extent possible. Be blessed by the divine. Be blessed by the divine. Be blessed by the divine. World prayer. May the leaders of every nation intuitively attain divine realization. The boundaries of all nations guarded by a force common to every country. May all men live without rancor or fear, working for a living, all wars disappear. May the people all over the world find lasting peace which fills their mind. Rain blessing. May there be rainfall and adequate strength so that lakes, ponds, wells, and rivers are filled to the brim. May people live in prosperity through ennoblement of character. May there be rainfall and adequate strength so that lakes, ponds, wells, and rivers are filled to the brim. May people live in prosperity through ennoblement of character. May there be rainfall and adequate strength so that lakes, ponds, wells, rivers are filled to the brim. May people live in prosperity through ennoblement of character. Be blessed by the divine. Be blessed by the divine. May the whole world enjoy prosperity, peace, and wisdom. May peace prevail within us. May peace prevail around us. May peace prevail all over the world. Peace, peace, peace. Be blessed by the divine. World, the world. Let us now move to the speech session. Today we have with us our guest of honor, a motivational speaker dedicated to the service of Vedatriyam, Dr. M.K. Janakiraman sir, to share his insights on the topic, the science of pranayama, in continuation of the science of series. Dr. Janakiraman sir is well known to all our Sky professors. Professor started his service with WCSC from 2002 onwards, and for the last 18 years, he is rendering his yeoman service to Vedatriyam. Initially, he was a coordinator for Sky Omen chapter. He is now a chief advisor for the Sky project. He is a psychologist and a family counselor and has counseled thousands of families in the last 20 years. He conducts classes at the Temple of Consciousness at Aliyar and actively involved in village service projects. He has been visiting the adopted villages and improves the quality of family life in those villages through counseling camps. He also visits schools and colleges to motivate and empower our youngsters. He is also involved in online courses conducted by Sky Yoga and has done special counseling sessions online for children, youth, and parents organized by Vision for Wisdom, which were loved and appreciated by all participants irrespective of age. Personally, he is a great source of inspiration for me. In his relentless service to humanity through Vedatriyam, coupled with humbleness and down-to-earth personality, a warm welcome to you, sir, for your esteemed presence with us today. Kindly proceed with your speech, sir.
Valga Vayagam, Valga Vayagam, Valga Valamudan. Be blessed by the divine. Thank you very much, Professor. Thank you for your introduction and opportunity given to me to share my insight on pranayama. Just a second, I'll just, okay. Okay, I'm just going to take a little time. Today, we all as Vedatriyans practice pranayama on a daily basis. It's part of our meditation exercises, part of our physical exercises, and possibly not a day passes without we doing some kind of pranayama other. But what is the science behind pranayama? The lungs in our body play a very important role in our daily living. Lungs and the cardiac area, your heart, they play a very, very vital role and they are very close to each other. They both share the kind of function that they do, exchanging gases, exchanging air, okay, which is extremely important for our living. Today, we're going to just see in a very brief as to what is the science behind pranayama. Today, if you see, pran means life force. Say pran shakti. Okay, pran means life. Pran means, okay, the life force that within us. Yama means extension, expansion. Okay, so basically, pranayama basically ensures that our life energy is extended, elongated. It is just absolutely in absolute tandem with what is required for the body. And what does it do? Helps us to eliminate the body waste. On a daily basis, the body secretes toxins from the liver, from all the organs in the body. Every organ wants to eliminate and excrete. And the toxins provide, for example, there are a lot of pollutions that we come across that became a toxin in the body. We eat food which is not very good for the body, become a toxin. There are medicines that we take in our system, which are toxins. So they got to be removed by the body. And here, okay, the pranayama, the breathing through the lungs plays an important role. Now, there are three aspects of breathing. We can say puraka, rechaka, and kumbhaka. Puraka means inhalation, it is taking in air through your nostrils. Rechaka is basically exhalation, that is sending out the air. And kumbhaka is basically holding the breath. Normally, pranayama is a huge area. There are hundreds of pranayama techniques available. But our Maharishi has given some important ones, which are very powerful ones also. In our system, we don't do kumbhaka at all, because we only play with puraka and rechaka. But there are techniques where they also practice kumbhakam. Because Maharishi has said clearly, when you hold your breath, what is that you are holding? What is they holding inside your lungs? You're essentially holding carbon dioxide. Is it toxic? It is not required. So holding carbon dioxide inside your body does not do any good for you. And if you definitely want to do kumbhaka, there's nothing wrong. But there are ways the kumbhaka has to be done. It's a very powerful technique. If it is not done the right measure properly, it can create problems for human the endocrine glands. Somewhere it can get locked. So Maharishi has told clearly that let us just practice only puraka and rechaka. That is good enough for a beautiful living and a healthy living. Now, what is the importance of pranayama? What does it do in the body? It utilizes the oxygen available optimally. In every breath, there's an amount of oxygen that goes inside your body. Pranayama ensures that it is used and the right measure. And it ensures, it enhances our cardiovascular performance. Cardiac and respiration. Your heart and your lung performance ensures. Because only when the air goes inside, it goes to the heart and the blood. The heart takes the oxygen and it purifies the blood and the waste blood. Okay, the accommodation from the blood goes again back to the lungs and gets excreted through lungs to the exhalation. And it also ensures your psychological health is very good. You're agitated. What happened to your pranayama? You'll be absolutely in a very subtle state. You'll not be able to, you'll not be able to breathe properly. So when you breathe properly, normally your health of psychology, your psychological health will be very good. Your mental health will be very good. See, I meet a lot of people who come with psychological disorders. I teach them some kind of a pranayama. When they practice this, I can see a huge good improvement in their psychic health. So it ensures that our psychological health is beautiful in order. And melatonin is a very important chemical that gets secreted in the pineal gland. And this also, proper pranayama will ensure your melatonin secretion is very good. Melatonin is the hormone, it's called sleep hormone. This is controlled by our body rhythm. It's called the circadian rhythm. The melatonin will not get secreted in the daytime. It only secreted in the night. It's a night chemical. Only when you sleep in the night, the body secretes melatonin. So when you do pranayama beautifully, your melatonin secretion is in order. Another thing is the improvement in your blood pressure and orthostatic tolerance. See, actually, in our body, the blood pressure has to be normal. There are people, when they suddenly stand up, the BP will go up. That's called the orthostatic tolerance. Because normally when you are sitting down, lying down, you move here and there, the BP should not vary much. But there are people, suddenly when they get up, the BP will go up. So such kind of things can be managed by pranayama. Then also, hypertension, ischemia and infarction. Okay, both ischemia and infarction is a disorder of your heart. So both functions can be managed, okay, when you do pranayama in a beautiful way. Now, nervous system is called the automatic nervous system, and it has two important types. One is called the sympathetic nervous system and the parasympathetic nervous system. See, the sympathetic nervous system, suppose you want to blink. Okay, suddenly you want to, something happens, you want to immediately react. It is managed by the sympathetic nervous system. Somebody is just coming to hit you. You want to move away, or you want to shout, or you want to do something. Okay, all the nervous function is managed, this happens by automatically without your involvement. That is done by the sympathetic nervous system. And your parasympathetic will ensure you retract, you become better. Because normally what happens sometimes, you're agitated, your mood is in a very bad shape. So the parasympathetic system works and brings the brings a good order into the nervous system. Now, when you do pranayama, primarily Nadi Shuddhi, okay, the ventricular, the complete performance of your heart and liver function, heart and lung function makes beautiful. What does this is, it increases the parasympathetic nervous system. Parasympathetic nervous system will ensure, okay, you don't get agitated. You are cool and composed. So, it will increase the activity of the parasympathetic nervous system and it will decrease the sympathetic nervous system which reacts to any situation. So, by doing both, your body ensures that you are absolutely in order and your nervous system does not get weakened. Now, there are many times we get into addictions. Okay, people get into addiction of alcohol, drugs. Okay, there are so many ways we get addicted. Addiction is basically a reward through the brain. Okay, there are a lot of biochemical changes happens when addiction happens. Somebody gets takes alcohol, some takes drugs. A lot of biochemical changes happen. Endorphin, it secretes too much. Endorphin is required, but secretion becomes too much. Something called the BNDF. Okay, which is the brain-derived, BDNF, the brain-derived neurotrophic factor, it also increases. And the feel-good hormone, suppose, for example, somebody takes alcohol, somebody takes a drug, immediately they get a high, they get a feeling, they get a good, very nice feeling. So, it gives a feeling that I'm flying, I'm doing extremely well. Okay, and in such cases, the body secretes a lot of chemicals, proteins, amino acids, peptides, lipids, and carbohydrates, which increase our mood. But is it good? Okay, to an extent it is good, but goes beyond a point. That is when you do all this through an external factor. I take some kind of addictive things. Okay, I take some, for example, cannabis. Okay, I mean, I do ganja, I take cannabis, I take all this. Okay, this it gives you the right nice mood. You feel very good, you feel happy. But beyond a point, it also harms your limbic system. So, but I want the same mood, I want the same good feeling, a feeling of well-being, I want to be very happy. Like, for example, I want another mind to be produced. So here, your yoga and pranayama will replace these addictive things and ensure, okay, your behavior is beautiful and you feel very, very happy. The mood is very positive. Actually, cardiac function and pranayama, I mean, and the lungs are totally related, very, very close to each other. When you do pranayama, studies show your reduction, stress levels are reduced. There's a huge reduction in your stress level. Because I see a lot of people who come to me, when they practice meditation and pranayama primarily, I see a huge change in their being in a very, very short time. Okay. So it is really, really good. Okay. When people do this and the stress is extremely low and the heart function. What happens is the heart gets dilates. The pranayama will dilate your heart. What happens normally is when you have a heart problem, you have ischemia. Okay. There are a lot of blocks. Okay. The walls get constricted. The passage of blood cannot go properly. When you do pranayama beautifully, the constriction, okay, the blockages, okay, they give way and the blood flow is absolutely smooth in the heart. Then if you see, let us understand, there are hundreds of pranayama techniques available. But let us take some three or four and understand how they work. There's something called the full yogic breath pranayama. Okay, where what happens here is it uses your complete abdomen, diaphragm and the chest. Your stomach, your chest area and the diaphragm. Diaphragm is the one which separates your abdomen and the chest. So the diaphragm, okay, whenever you breathe, okay, it just constricts and it manages, ensures that your lungs are completely pressed and the full oxygen is taken inside. And when you release carbon dioxide, it goes back to normal position. So it keeps on alternating. Okay, so all the three, your entire three stage of breathing happens here. So the full breath, okay, yogic pranayama. Okay. Then you have the anuloma vinuloma, okay, which is basically our nadi shruti, which you do prior to meditation. This is called the alternate nostril breathing. You close your right nostril first, you inhale through your left nostril as much as possible. Exhale through the right and you again inhale through the right and exhale through the left. So this is another beautiful pranayama. See, nadi shuddhi is also one wonderful technique. Suppose you are stressed. Suppose you go to meet somebody important. You feel a little worried. You're not very sure. Sit about 10 to 15 minutes. Do nadi shuddhi. You'll feel absolutely comfortable. Suppose your children are there. They're going for the examination. They feel stressed. They feel worried. Then go to the examination hall about half an hour advance, just prior to the examination starts. Then you spend about 15 minutes doing nadi shuddhi. They'll feel absolutely relaxed. It's an excellent technique. Suppose, for example, yesterday a lady called me. She said, I'm having a very heavy headache. I'm not able to manage at all. It's a menstrual time and it is extremely difficult for me to manage what I should do. I told her just 15 minutes to do nadi shuddhi. Half an hour later, she called me and said she's fine. So, nadi shuddhi is a beautiful pranayama, okay, which Maharishi gives a lot of emphasis on nadi shuddhi. And we have the abdominal pumping, you know, kapalapati, with forceful exhalation and inhalation, okay, which we do as part of our exercises, is an excellent pranayama for cleansing your entire body. There's a pranayama called the ocean breath pranayama, where you use your vocal breath and they make a sound from the throat called the Ujjayi pranayama. Okay, which also, there is another technique as you should do. Now, what happens here? In our body, there are something called the Surya Kalaya and Chandra Kalaya Pranayama. Here, we do right nostril breathing or left nostril breathing. When you do the right nostril breathing, it is activatory. It is basically the Surya Nadi. Okay. Including activating a Surya Nadi, it enhances the performance of the entire body. The entire oxygen consumption is increased. The body becomes very active and it enhances your sympathetic and stimulating effect. When you do left nostril breathing, it is relaxatory in nature. You are composed, you are cool. The oxygen consumption comes down. Your heart rate, your BP, your respiration, everything comes down. So depending upon what is required, well, I want to go and relax. I want to sleep. Then you must do left nostril breathing. No, I want to be active. I want to go for a project. I want to go to the office. I want to do some work. I want to study. Then your Surya Nadi will work better where you do the right nostril breathing. Now, there's a beautiful chemical called the nitric oxide, NO, which has one unit of nitrogen and one unit of oxygen. What does this do? Okay. Your nitric oxide is one important chemical in the body, which is important for the body function. And the secretion of nitric oxide reduces the age when you are very young. Okay. Nitric oxide, secretion in the body is very good. But as you get older and older, slowly the nitric oxide comes down. Okay, why is it required? It's required because it ensures the delivery of oxygen to every cell is maintained. The oxygen from the body goes to every cell in the body. So the nitric oxide ensures the travel of the oxygen to every cell. And it expands the blood vessels. Because the blood vessels expand, okay, the kind of flow of the blood will be very good. So nitric oxide ensures that. Then the next one is, it prevents blood clots. It doesn't allow, okay, the blood to stay in anywhere. Okay, the people have a hemophilic problem. They have something called the Bieder's disease. All these kind of people, for them, when this blood clot is managed through nitric oxide, they feel absolutely blissful. And the blood pressure is regulated through this. And there are people who have sexual issues. Okay, they have problem with their libido. Okay, such people, for them, the nitric oxide is very, very useful. And it also ensures, some people have a problem with their mind, their thinking capability, the cognitive faculty, okay, has a problem. So for them, it ensures that nitric oxide will ensure this problem does not happen. In our body, we all have the cholesterol. We have the good cholesterol and the bad cholesterol. We have the HDL and the LDL. HDL is the chemical which is not required. Sorry, HDL is a chemical which you require in the body. The HDL cholesterol is a good cholesterol. And we require this on a daily basis. The higher the HDL is good for your body. The LDL is low-density hyperpropyl and is not required. And it will ensure this LDL becomes reduced in your body. And when people have some kidney problems, nitric oxide ensures your kidney failures are reversed or problems are not there in that. And the whole body gets absolutely energized. And also the immunity gets very built very well. And the brain, the process, neuroplasticity in the brain increases. So nitric oxide has so many functions for the whole body. But why I'm talking about this here? When you do pranayama, your nitric oxide gets produced naturally. Today, we have a lot of vegetables, greens, okay, all the leafy vegetables, all the dark colored vegetables, they provide you with nitric oxide. And there are a lot of supplements in the world. Today, many people, doctors prescribe NO supplements because the body does not secrete properly. So such people, they'll be taking supplements, which are chemicals that affect the body. But when you do pranayama naturally, the body secretes a lot of nitric oxide and ensures all these problems are not there. We saw so many issues of how the body manages. So when you are doing pranayama beautifully, okay, all the pranayama techniques will ensure nitric oxide, secretion is very, very high. But one beautiful thing is, okay, and where it is produced? In the parasinuses. We all the sinuses in our facial area. So it's produced there. And the Om chanting, all the heard of this Om chanting, we use the entire body. Okay, from there, lower your belly area or lower than, from your Mooladharam, okay, the entire vibration in the body happens when you do chant Om. When you chant Om, it is found technically, the study says, the production of nitric oxide becomes 15 times more than the normal secretion. So this pranayama will also help to ensure the nitrogen is very high and a body performance is beautiful. Now, what Maharishi has given us? Maharishi has done a lot of research. He's seen all kinds of pranayamas. Okay, he's done a lot of study on his own body. Finally, he says, let us manage with two important techniques. Okay, we give a lot of priority for these things. But of course, we also do some other meditation, other things that we do. But these two important ones. See, Nadi Shuddhi, as I told earlier, will ensure your body functions are in order. And Kapalabhati will do cleansing of your body. So if we all do these two important techniques on a daily basis, most of our problems will be completely sorted out. Now, what are the benefits of pranayama? Many diseases can be completely controlled. It detoxifies the body. As I told earlier, a lot of toxic waste in the body. These waste get eliminated and also ensure that they don't stay in the body at all. And your digestion becomes very good. Many times when your lung function is not very good, when your energy is not properly flowing, when you're having some, say, wheezing issues, asthma issues, allergic issues, your digestion suffers. But when you do pranayama properly, digestion will be in order. And when you do pranayama, your concentration and focus, your mental faculties work beautiful. And of course, the capacity of the lungs expand too much. See, we all think lung is very small. What is the size of a lung? Actually, if you imagine, the lung is of a fist size, very small size actually. But it is many, 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 many folds. It has many, many layers. Suppose I take the lung. I spread the lung over, say, a small place. The entire lung, as I expand, can cover a beautiful, huge football court. Such is the size of a lung. So when you do pranayama, your entire lung will get activated. The capacity will go really up. And also the scientific study says, if you see the complete airways, there are so many alveoli. Okay, they just call the sacs of where the air goes inside. The airways of the entire lungs, if you just measure the distance, it is a beautiful number. It is 1,500 miles. 1,500 miles, you can't believe it. About 2,500 kilometers. That is the length of the alveoli, the length of the air passage. Okay. And it is, mind-boggling number. And when you do this, your stress levels come down. Your body gets completely relaxed. And you get beautiful control on yourself. You can manage yourself completely. And your mind and body is absolutely relaxed. And overall, your physical, your mental, emotional, spiritual, intellectual, and social well-being is maintained, and you are absolutely blissful. So on that note, I want to thank all of you for the time given to me, and be blessed by the divine. Now, if you have any questions, I can take the questions. So I request you to raise your hand, and we can take any question that you may ask. If we know the answer, I'll share with you, or we can find the answer together. Thank you very much. I want to thank the organizers of this Zoom function, and I want to thank the Compeer Madam, okay, Madam Radha, and everybody else here, okay, who gave the opportunity for this session. Thank you very much. Valga Vallamudan.
Thank you very much, sir, for adding one more flower of enlightening speech to your garland of science of series. With a detailed presentation, you have explained the various benefits of pranayama and its importance for keeping ourselves healthy, free from accumulation of toxins, which is the basic reason for diseases. We have understood clearly that practicing proper breathing will also help in maintaining calm, composure for better self-management emotionally, socially, and intellectually. Thank you so much, sir, for the very short and intellectual speech. We move on to our important announcements. Before
you start raising the question. COVID is still not over, and the need of the hour is higher immunity level with people coming out in large numbers devoid of safety measures. For gaining immunity, we have the ancient practice of Siddhas called Kayakalpa Yoga, which is now available as online course. Visit kayakalpayoga.edu.in to learn this technique from the comfort of your home and stay healthy. Download the Android app and recommend it to your friends and relatives. Visit kundaliniyoga.edu.in to learn all Sky courses in online mode in the language of your ease. They are offered in English, Tamil, and Kannada. Check Anvali app on Android phones to access or download our Swamiji's precious speeches. Sky Yoga TV is our YouTube channel and Facebook page. Connect with them and subscribe to get notifications about all our programs and listen to all past speeches of our professors on various concepts of Sky Yoga. Join our special meditation session for Guinness World Record on 28 March 2021 at 6 p.m. by individually subscribing to Sky Yoga TV YouTube channel. Click the notification button for updates. Donate generously to the World Community Service Center through Anvali app or vidadri.edu.in, our prime website. Income tax exemption under ATG are available for all donations. It's time for us to express our gratitude. Let us all come to Durya Street to bless our Professor Janakiraman sir for his excellent speech. Professor M.K. Janakiraman sir, be blessed by the divine. His good health, be blessed by the divine. His loving family, be blessed by the divine. His divine services, be blessed by the divine. We would like to extend our blessings to the Sky Meditators for their kind donations yesterday. Your generous donations will help us a lot to serve the society. By the grace of the divine, may you and your family enjoy good health, long life, enough wealth, prosperity, wisdom, and peace. Be blessed by the divine. We are happy to bring the following online programs live from Alaya Temple of Consciousness tomorrow at 5:15 a.m. 9 Center Meditation in Tamil, 6 a.m. Exercises in Tamil, 7 a.m. 9 Center Meditation in English, 11 a.m. Speech in Tamil by Professor Ganeshan Chennai on the topic Maunathin Minmai. Evening program details, 6 p.m. Durya Meditation in Tamil, 6:30 p.m. Speech in Tamil by Professor Dominic Vincent Thirunelveli on the topic Enniye Mudidal Vendum, 8 p.m. Shanti Meditation, 8:15 p.m. Speech in English on topic Heal Your Soul with Forgiveness by Professor Janaka Veeraraghavan Chennai. Please share the program invites with your friends and relatives to get more people benefited through our practices. Now, we move on to the question answer session. If anyone is wanting to ask questions to our professor, kindly raise your hand.
Yes, ma'am. Tejaswini.
Unmute yourself and ask your question.
Varaha Valamudan, sir. So this is Tejaswini from Bangalore, sir.
Yes, ma'am.
Sir, today's session you had explained about the science of pranayama. Actually, after attending this session only, I understood that so many deep informations are hidden when we do pranayama, sir. It was really a great session. So I just want to check that you were mentioned that melatonin, right? This we get it only when we are in sleep, right, sir?
Yeah.
But people who live in the cities usually have very less time to do exercise or for us to take care of our health. In that case, which one to give more priority, sir? Doing yoga or meditation or, sleeping for 8 hours or 6 hours or whatever according to the body. So what is your suggestion on the basis of good health, sir?
Super. Very good question, man. Very good question. See, ma'am, actually, you, when you do your sky exercises properly,
yes, sir,
your time will be saved. For example, morning when you get up, say 5 o'clock you get up, or 6 o'clock you get up. First, complete your kayakalpa, 3 minutes. Then, do your exercises, 40 minutes. Then, do your meditation, another 20 minutes. That one and a half hour, one hour and 10 minutes, you spend every day for your body and mind, on a daily basis, you will save 3 to 4 hours. How? Because whatever work you do, you are studying, or you are going to office, or doing your work at home. Okay, every work of yours, you will save time because it will be of quality. There will be concentration, there will be focus, and you will save time. Suppose you are a student. Tejesh is a student. You are studying one chapter. Suppose you are not doing meditation at all. You are not doing any exercises at all. When you study a chapter, it will take, suppose, 6 to 1 hour. Because you are getting defocused, your mind is wandering here and there. So it will take 1 hour. Suppose you become a good meditator, you do practice properly, after something, study some other subject, the same thing will take only half an hour. In half an hour, you will finish the whole thing. And very important thing is, why? Because the mind is not wandering. When you are completely focused, there is concentration. Another very important thing is, earlier when you had a mind wandering, the mind of focus was not there, whatever you studied, you will forget. Now you are focusing, mind is not wandering. When you do this, whatever you study, you will not forget. So by doing this, every one of us can save 3 to 4 hours in a day. Now, coming to your question on melatonin. Melatonin is the sleep hormone. Okay, why hormone is required? In our body, there are 12 important organs, like your heart, your liver, your kidney, okay, pancreas, you take your gallbladder, okay, all this, there are about 12 organs are there. And there is a timeline for every organ. Which organ should excrete at what time? Not only anus muscles excrete, every organ excretes. They do kind of a elimination of waste, they do. And there's a time. Okay, the time is managed by a biological clock. The clock is called the circadian rhythm. The circadian rhythm, to happen properly on a daily basis, you require melatonin. So if melatonin is not there, your circadian rhythm will not work properly and your body waste will not get eliminated properly. So what you should do, okay, sleep only in the night, because this melatonin will not get secreted when you're sleeping in the daytime. The sunshine, when there's a sun in the sun there, your body will not secrete melatonin. So what you should do is sleep only. But you may ask a question, I'm in the city, I'm working for US time, working for a London time, so how can I sleep in the night? Yes, your body will have a problem. You are a young lady, nothing will happen now. When you become 30 years, 40 years, your body will misbehave. Today we see many children of young age, they have problem with their stomach. They have ulcers. Okay, they have gastritis. They have IBS. They have menstrual problems. Why? Because in the young age, they are not focusing. They are not sleeping properly in the night. So all I want to tell you, ma'am, okay, if you sleep properly, do our exercise properly, you will save 3 to 4 hours. Even if you sleep for 5 hours, 6 hours is good enough. That will happen with sky practices, definitely. So people like you, okay, you must sleep only in the nighttime and not sleep in the daytime. But if you're doing the exercises, your total sleep time can come down. Thank you so much. Valga varamudan. Madam Ranjini, I admitted you. You can talk, ask the question, ma'am. Madam Ranjini? Madam Tejashwini, I have answered your question.
Madam, have you?
Yes, sir. Thank you for your valuable answer, sir. It was a great help for your answer, sir. Thank you so much, sir.
Be blessed by the
divine.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
In Nadi Suddhi, for aspirants, what can we suggest? Equal time in left and right, or double the time, 1:2? What is the best way for aspirants, newcomers?
Yeah, ma'am. To start with. Do equal time.
Okay.
Because you get practice to the technique of the Nadi Shuddhi. Because okay, if we say that you do 1:2, 1:4, then they will not do properly. Once you get the practice, then make it 1:2.
Okay. Start with
one. Okay. Start with just 1:1. Suppose you say that normally what happens in Nadi Shuddhi is when you do normal breathing without any pranayama, you will do about 18 breaths in a minute.
Okay.
But when you do Nadi Shuddhi, you'll come to about 5, 6 or 7. So what you should do is, once you get some practice, then make this into 1:2. You can even do 1:4 later.
Okay.
Okay, it's possible. Okay.
After they get the Turiya meditation, can we increase the time? The 1:2?
Actually, it is not meditation time, ma'am. It is the time you do Nadi Shuddhi and practice Nadi Shuddhi.
Before the time, after they get the Turiya, they are eligible to do 1:2 after they.
That's what I'm saying. What I'm saying is, it is not, Turiya is not the criteria. The criteria is how good they are able to do Nadi Shuddhi. They're comfortable, they can even do much, even in Agnya they can do, no problem at all.
Okay.
Yeah. Thank you, ma'am. Madam Gayatri, Walgol.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
I joined in the middle only, sorry. My question is, how do the this breathing exercises helps to reduce our migraine pain or any headache?
Yeah. Okay. Actually, the migraine pain happens because there's a lot of, basically what happens, you're tensed, you're worried, something is bothering you, your nervous system doesn't work properly. When you do Nadi Shuddhi or you do any pranayama for that matter, okay, what happens is the blood flow, the oxygen flow to the entire body, primarily to the nervous system, becomes very good. For example, I take X amount of oxygen into my body, 80% of the oxygen goes to the brain. So that's where your problem happens with all your headaches, all your problems happens here. So when you have breathed a lot of, when you're doing an Nadi Shuddhi or any pranayama technique, you're taking a lot of air for every breath. When you do proper pranayama, for every breath, the intake of your oxygen is increased manifold. So that oxygen goes to your brain, and your complete neurological system works perfectly. So that way, continuous performance, definitely any of your, neurological function, including all the headaches, migraine, but there are so many headaches that are possible, can be definitely controlled, ma'am.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Who's next? Any more questions, please?
No more questions, I believe, sir. Shall we conclude, sir?
Okay, ma'am. Thank you very much, ma'am. Thank you, Madam Radha, madam. Thank you so much.
Welcome. Thank you, sir. Sir, thanks a lot, sir, for the nice question and answer session, giving insights on the importance of pranayama. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you.
Our beloved president, Arunidhi Padmashri S.K. Mailanandam, sir, for his leadership, continuous support and guidance. Looking forward to seeing you all tomorrow. Till then, stay safe and practice our Kundalini Yoga. This is Radha Ravichandra, signing off from the Aliyar World Community Service Center, ITT. Be blessed by the divine. Let us conclude the session with world blessing. May the world be blessed with plenty of rain. The farmers work to produce an abundance of grain. Let practitioners of all prosper, flourish and grow. And culture progress through the need to share and grow. Let the rulers be beyond feelings of anger or fear. Illiteracy, poverty and all evils made to disappear. Let the true lamp of knowledge burn steady and bright. Our sense of duty guides us along paths always right. Our sense of duty guides us along paths always right. Be blessed by the divine. Be blessed by the divine.